Hey, what's going on, everybody? Jake here with Venter Visuals, and today I am so hyped because we're going to be breaking down Premiere Pro transition presets, where you can find them, how to install them, and how you can use them to speed up your workflow and elevate your next visual. If you use Premiere Pro, you probably know that there's only a few default transitions built into the software. These transitions are very basic and not really useful for people who want flashy edits. Personally, I edit a lot of music videos, I've edited a lot of skateboarding videos, and I've also edited a lot of vlogs. So it was important to me to design a preset pack full of transitions that would be useful for different types of content. And I know you guys are gonna find these Premiere Pro transition presets incredibly useful for your own edits as well. I just wanna give a quick shout out to everybody in this community who has subscribed to the channel. We just passed 10,000 subscribers. I'm feeling incredibly blessed. Thank you guys for helping me grow this community. Honestly, I think one of my favorite parts of this process has been watching you guys grow creatively, get better at editing, and I've been able to connect with so many of you through my Instagram account as well, and it's just been an amazing process. So if you're excited to see how these transition presets can elevate your next visual within seconds, hit the like button down below and let's get into it. We're gonna be using some Premiere Pro transition presets from my Blueprints pack today. So when you download the Blueprints pack, you'll see it here in your downloads as a zip file. You're going to double click on this file to expand it, and it's going to open a regular folder. So now I'm gonna double click into this folder, and we got a couple files here. This file is going to be our transition presets, and then included in the Blueprints pack are 30 4K overlays as well. So if I open this folder up, we can see all the overlays here. And what I'm going to do with these overlays is just select them and drag them onto our timeline. Also included in every pack on my website is a walkthrough guide. If we click on this walkthrough guide and hit spacebar, it's going to give us a quick instruction manual on how you can use this pack. From here, I'm just going to close out of this window for now, and we're going to install the Premiere Pro transition presets. So in order to install the Blueprints pack, what we're going to do is come to our effects tab in Premiere. We're going to select our preset folder. We're going to right click on it and hit import presets. Then you'll just navigate to the Blueprints folder, and we're going to import this file right here. So I'm just going to click it and hit open. Now in Premiere Pro, under our presets folder, you can see we have our Blueprints folder. And as I expand that, you can see all 30 Premiere Pro transition presets. Now what we're going to do is start at the cut between these two clips. We're going to hold shift and go to the left once. That's going to go to the left 5 frames of the cut. And now we're going to hold shift and go to the right twice. So now we're going to the right 5 frames of the cut as well. And now I'm going to click V to switch back to my cursor. I'm going to highlight both of these clips, right click, and hit nest. This is going to kind of sandwich those two clips together right at the cut. So you can see there, it's all one clip now. And from this point, all we have to do is drag and drop the transition preset we want onto this nested sequence, and it's going to work instantly. In the most recent update on my Blueprints pack, I included some more kind of glitchy transitions that I thought were necessary for the pack to have. So the first transition preset we're going to try today is this one called Bad TV, and we're going to click and drag it onto our nested sequence. Now you can see right away, the transition starts to impact our footage, and over here under our effect controls, you can see every effect that goes into making this transition happen. Over here, a little bit farther to the right, you can also see all of the keyframe values that are changing throughout this transition preset. And this is why I think presets are so valuable, because instead of having to create this transition from scratch, you already have it made and keyed for you. You don't have to do much to get this looking perfect. So what we're going to do now is render this out in our timeline. You can see our timeline has turned red because there's so many effects getting used on this transition preset. So what we're going to do is start at the left side of this transition. We're going to hit I on our keyboard. Now come to the right and hit O to mark our in and out points. And then what we're going to do is come up here to sequence and hit render into out. Now that it's rendered, you can see our timeline turns green here. And as I play it back, boom, you can see we get a nice transition preset that looks really dope. If I don't like this specific preset for this clip, what I'm going to do is hit Command Z until it undoes itself off of the nested sequence. And now I can click and drag another one of these presets onto our clip. Let's try this one that's new with the update. It's called Strobe Slide. It's one of my new favorites. I'm going to click and drag that onto our nested sequence. And you can see this one uses a little bit of less effects, so it's not as computer intensive. We're not getting that red line, which means we don't necessarily have to render this out to play it back at full speed. So now as I play this back, you can see, boom, it's a really nice transition. We got a little slide action happening. We get some blur happening. We get some flash happening. We get a little bit of that color tint in there as well. And you can play around with each of these transition presets and customize them more to your liking over here under the effect panels. If we just wanna, you know, play around with some of these transition presets, all we have to do is select the FX button next to some of the effects that go into creating these transition presets. Now, if I turn this effect called four color gradient off and on, you can see it changes the color of our clip there during the transition. So maybe I don't want this color overlay to happen while this transition is happening. What I can do is turn the effects off for that specific effect. And now when we play it back, there is no color change and it still looks really cool. These transition presets are really designed to give you a really solid starting point when it comes to designing your own transitions, customizing the look of your own visuals. And you can see it's very easy to dive right in and start changing these transition presets around if you would like to. A little bit farther down my timeline here, you can see we got some more clips from the same video, and I've already created nested sequences in between each of these clips so that we can start applying these transition presets in bulk to this visual. So with my blueprints pack open, what I'm going to do is just start clicking and dragging these transition presets on some of these nested sequences, and you guys can see just how quickly this process goes here. So I'm just going to click a few more of these transition presets, just clicking and dragging them onto our nested sequences that we've created in between our clips. All right, so now we can watch it all play back at full speed here. So boom, we got a nice basic swipe, got a little burn, got a little glitch. So you can see this pack just has a little bit of everything, and it's really, really useful for really any type of edit. I particularly use this pack for music video edits, but you can also use this pack for vlogs, for skate edits, for hype edits, for sport edits, whatever it is. This pack just has a lot of really unique transitions that are really beneficial for speeding up your workflow. Now, also included in the pack are these 30 transitions that kind of work with the transition presets. These transitions are designed in 4K quality, and right now we're on a 1920 by 1080 timeline. So what we have to do is highlight all of these overlays. We're going to right click on them and hit scale to frame size. This is just going to shrink them down so that nothing's getting cut out around the edges. I'm just going to preview some of these overlays for you guys. So we've got some new ones that I just put into the pack with the last update, but we've got a lot of really practical overlays here that are really creative and are meant to work alongside of the transition presets that are also included in the pack. So I'm going to show you guys a little bit more about what that means, what I'm talking about, and how you can use these overlays to really bump up the quality of your visuals as well alongside of the transition presets included in the pack. So there you go, you've seen all of the overlays now. What we can do is just pick out a few of these overlays that we think would look cool in our edit. So I really like this one. This one's a red glitch. This one here is like a really nice classic kind of look for a glitch as well. So what I'm going to do is just take this glitch. We're going to move it over some of our footage on our timeline. So we're going to place it above. Let's just place it above some of this footage that we've just been editing here. So boom, it's on video layer 2 now. Now when you place an overlay above your footage, you're gonna notice that we still have this black background peeking through and we're not seeing our footage underneath the overlay. So what we have to do with our overlay selected is come up here to blend mode. We're going to change it from normal to any other blend mode here, but I particularly like the screen blend mode. I think it looks the best. So now as I play back this clip, you can see the glitch overlay happening on top of this clip. It looks really, really nice. Now I suggest using these overlays with the transition presets. And what I mean by that is stacking the overlays on some of our transition preset areas. So I'm just going to stack this overlay on top of this transition right here. And we're going to render this out so it plays back at full speed. And now as I play it back, you can see we get a nice glitch happening with our transition preset, and it just kind of helps add that little bit of extra sauce to the edit as well. Let's try one more overlay on top of some of our footage. So I'm gonna take this one called Edge. I'm going to hit Command C here. I'm going to hit Command V to paste it. What we have to do is switch our blend mode from normal down to screen so our footage starts to leak through there. I like to use these as kind of more transitions. So let's play that back. Boom, right there. It's really nice, subtle transition. Now, another thing about these overlays is if you want to change the color of them and customize them even more, what you can do under your effects tab is type in an effect called Color Balance HLS, throw that onto an overlay, and we can change the hue of the overlay to a different color to get an even more unique look. So that is an option as well, guys. So I know I mentioned before that these transition presets can be used in a variety of different projects, not just music video edits, but vlogs, skateboarding videos, sport edits as well. So I wanna give another quick example of what these transition presets look like on some footage that's not a music video. So here down my timeline, I've got some skate clips of my buddy Tyler. He absolutely shreds. We've spent a lot of time skateboarding together in the past, filming videos, and I've got a ton of skate clips saved on my computer. So what I'm going to do is just kind of demo some of these transition presets in between some of these skate clips, and we're going to do it really, really quickly. So what we're going to do is start at each cut, hold shift, go to the left once, hold shift, go to the right twice, nest those two, boom, just like so. And now I'm going to come to my blueprints pack. Let's go ahead and try this one called Heavy Glitch on this one. And then we'll just scroll to our next transition where these two clips meet. We're gonna hold shift, go to the left once, hold shift, go to the right twice, right click on those and hit nest. And then on this one, we can try, let's use this one. Let's go ahead and roll with the swipe tilt. So let's throw a swipe tilt on this one. And then our last transition here at the end, hold shift, go to left once, hold shift, go to the right twice, boom, nesting. In progress, boom, we got it. You can see how easy it is to prepare your clips to throw these transition presets on. So on this last one, let's go ahead and do this one called Crisscross. Let's throw that one on there as well. All right, so here we go, played back at full speed. We got a banging 50-50 on the quarter pipe. Boom, glitch transition, looks amazing. Hard flip down some stairs, little swipe tilt, boom, looks dope. Little varial heel over some stairs. Amazing, we got another transition. So you can see how useful transition presets are in speeding up your workflow. You can really add some extra sauce to your edit in seconds using these transition presets. I spent months designing this pack, making sure that each preset in this pack was useful, creative, and practical for a multitude of different projects. I know for a fact that this Blueprints Transitions pack is going to help a lot of you guys level up your future visual projects. I've been using the Blueprint Transitions preset pack on a lot of my recent projects. It's really helped speed up my workflow and it's given me a lot of ideas creatively. And these transition presets are really cool once you start getting into more rotoscoping, adding more effects based in After Effects and combining them with some of these Premiere Pro transition presets. Now, if you're not looking to get the full pack today, that's totally fine. You can still download my free pack that includes a couple transition presets for free, as well as a few overlays so you can start elevating your next visual today. If that sounds interesting to you, make sure to check the links out below in the description. Again, I really appreciate you guys for watching my videos and getting this community to 10,000 subscribers. It's a huge blessing. I never would have thought this channel would have grown so much in the past year, and I'm really excited for what the future holds for this community. If you have any questions or concerns, please feel free to comment them down below. I try to answer everybody who comments on this channel, or if you need some immediate help, feel free to hit me up on Instagram at VentorVisuals. I'm super excited to see what you guys are going to create with this transition preset pack, so don't forget to send me your work on Instagram. And again, I really appreciate everybody who tunes in and watches my content. Until next time, I'm Jake Benner. Peace out.